Okay, it's Saturday, and that means we're off to our first wedding of 2019, and we're going to a familiar place today. It's called Sowell Farms. I know I've done a lot of barn weddings, and it might be hard to tell them apart, but the Sowell Farms is a one that we haven't been to in probably a couple years now, and all the barns really look similar around here, so you're probably going to recognize this one. But this is the one where they had the camel and the donkey in the back that are best friends. I don't know if you remember that or not. You can look back at some of my previous gig logs, I think from around 2016, I think it was the last time we were here. But yeah, anyway, really nice place. It's out in the middle of the country and a very popular place to get married. And what I understand, I've heard that they've added a few things there too since the last time we were there, so I'm really looking forward to going out there. Now, this is a very nice bride and groom. They actually booked with me over a year ago. You know, we've had meetings and talked to them and, you know, gotten everything together. And we're going to be doing something a little different with their first dance. Let me explain to you how that's going to work. What I'm going to do is when we do the wedding party introductions is I'm going to start their first dance song and they're actually going to get introduced to their song and then go immediately into their first dance without it changing, you know what I'm saying? So their first dance song is actually going to be the song that they're going to walk into the reception hall to and then go right into their first dance. I've never, you know, actually done that before. Usually, you know, we'll have a song if they want to do their first dance right after the wedding party introductions. We'll normally play a song for them to get introduced and then I would say, okay, now we're going to, you know, do the bride and groom's first dance and then I would switch to the first dance song. But they actually wanted to cut to be introduced to their first dance song, go right into us. That's how we're going to do that. And that's going to be a neat thing as well. Anyway, it's about 1 o'clock now. The ceremony is supposed to start about 4 o'clock this afternoon. We're doing the sound for the ceremony as well. It's going to be right outside. And then the reception will be following right after that. So anyway, we'll be talking to you throughout the day. It's going to be a fun day. And you know what? The weather seems to be holding up right now. We did see some rain here earlier. So hopefully it'll hold off at least in time to get the ceremony done. Okay, so here we are at the Sowell Farms in Milton, Florida. Like I said, we've been here before, and let me show you my setup. Set up in the same spot as we were about 2 years ago, I guess. And there we go. We got our normal light show out, the Revo 3, Revo 4. Got the Galaxian 3D there as well. And our park ends there on the speaker stands. Now, the ceremony is actually going to be taking place outside. I'm getting ready to go out there in just a little bit to get set up the Fender Passport, you know, the smaller sound system. And we'll be getting ready for that, and we'll be back here in a little bit later to do the reception. So I'm going to go ahead and get set up for the ceremony and get dressed and all that good stuff. We've got about an hour now before the ceremony is supposed to start, so doing real good on time. Okay, we're outside now for the ceremony. Here's where the ceremony is taking place. That is my system. Got the Fender Passport out. And you see the guests starting to arrive. And what they've done is the guests, most of them are staying at a hotel, and they got a shuttle that's shuttling back and forth. Like I said, we're kind of out in, you know, out in nowhere. I'm not gonna say nowhere, but this will be a very hard location to find if you're not familiar with the area. That's why they have a shuttle bus. It makes it easier for them. So anyway, it's a country road you have to go on to get here. But yeah, really nice place out here. I tell you what, I really like it here. And back up there, that's the barn. That's where the reception is gonna be held. So you can see it's kind of overcast here right now. Wind's gusting up a little bit. And if you want to see what I look like right now, voila, there you go. All right, we'll be getting things started here in just a little bit. I'll wake you up with some. Oh,
photographers are getting ready to leave. We still got another hour left in the reception, but basically we have everybody line up outside doing the sparkler send-off, just like it was the end of the reception, except it's not. So anyway, that's why we're doing that right now. They're going to come back in here and start the dancing here just a little bit again. So hey, look at this room. This is a really nice facility. This is one of my favorite facilities to come and do an event, for sure. Real easy loading. I love it here. They do a wonderful job at this here at Sowell Farms. It's over. Time to pack up and head out. Here's one more look at my setup before I start packing up. Right there. Okay, we'll do a wrap from the road here in a little bit.
Alrighty, it's about 11:15 now. I'm on my way home, and this is the town of Milton, Florida, about 20 miles east of Pensacola. And you can tell everything's pretty much shut down here. There's not really too many cars out on the road, and that's what you expect in small town America, that's for sure. I think everybody around here goes to Pensacola to go party. But anyway, let's talk about the gig log that you just saw. It went great. It was a great wedding and another wonderful bride and groom, and they had a great group of friends and family. And this was a group that really liked to party. I have to admit that. They, I've always said this, but if you get enough alcohol in people, they're going to get out there and have a good time. And I think this crowd did too. And of course, they had the shuttle bus to take them back to the hotel, which was really good. And that way they didn't have to drive, you know, and all that kind of stuff. Because, you know, it is real easy to get turned around coming out of that place if you don't know where you're going, you know, late at night too. Because that the facility we were at is actually, kind of out in the country. You know, you saw how it looked like a bar and everything. So it is kind of out in the country, and it would be easy for somebody who doesn't know how to get there to get turned around. But anyway, I wanted to mention to you about the camel and the donkey that we've seen there before. Baghdad and Catfish were their names. They were best friends. Well, we found out that the original owners took them with them when they sold the property. And they've got a new camel there named Charlie. So that's pretty neat to see. He was a nice camel. I didn't really get him on the video too much. But they also had some zebras and some kangaroos there too, which I didn't find out about until later on in the evening after it was dark. Otherwise, I'd have taken the video camera out and got those. You can see kangaroos in Florida. That was pretty neat. So anyway, this was another wonderful bride and groom. Had a great time. And, I really wish them all the best. And we got more gig logs to come. So until next time, practice and enjoy. I'll wake you up with some.